Hey everyone, my name is Si. I'm an economics expert, and today we're going to learn about markets and competition. All right, let's get started. Let's start with the topics we're going to cover today. First, we're going to learn what is a market. Then, we're going to learn what is competition. And lastly, we're going to look at some examples of perfect competition. Let's dive into our first objective. What is a market? A market is simply a group of buyers and sellers offering some good or service coming together. It's a way for buyers and sellers to contact one another and exchange goods or services. Markets take on many forms. Some markets are relatively centralized, such as a farmer's market. Here, many sellers and buyers of fresh produce come together at a specific time and place to exchange goods. They all come together in a centralized place to conduct their businesses. But many markets are not centrally organized. Take a look at this delicious picture of ice cream. You could buy ice cream at many types of stores in all sorts of towns and cities. There are even ice cream trucks that come around to different neighborhoods. There's not one single person organizing these exchanges or calling out prices like an auctioneer. Yet, the price of ice cream is still generally pretty close from store to store, despite these stores existing in so many different locations. Why is that? This relates to our second topic. What is competition? This is when there are many buyers and sellers for the same good or service. In a competitive market, each buyer or seller has negligible impact on the price of a good. Let's take another look at that ice cream example. Let's say, for simplicity, that there are three ice cream shops close to your house, and they sell an ice cream cone for these prices shown, all between $4 to $5. Generally, they are pretty close because they are making relatively the same product, using similar inputs. And so you're pretty indifferent between going to each of these stores, so you can buy from each of them occasionally. But what if one of these stores got greedy and decided that they wanted to charge $10 for a cone? Well, now you are way less likely to go to that store because you have other options. So you are going to choose the cheaper stores. Competition goes the other way too. What if you decided that you don't want to pay $4 or $5 for a cone and instead you just want to pay $1? Could you demand that these stores sell you a cone for $1? The answer is no, because these stores have plenty of other customers to sell to, so they aren't going to sell it to you for $1 when they can sell it to others for their regular price. So in essence, competition is simply having multiple options. The price of ice cream cones will converge on what sellers are willing to sell for and what buyers are willing to buy for. Our last topic is perfect competition. This is a scenario where the goods being sold are perfectly identical, and there are so many buyers and sellers that not one single buyer or seller can impact the price. This will be an assumption that you will use for many concepts later in macroeconomic topics you will cover. The characteristics of perfect competition are 1. A homogeneous product, which means that goods or services being sold are the exact same across all firms. 2. There is a large number of buyers and sellers, so that no one buyer or seller can influence the market price. 3. Free entry and exit for firms in the market, meaning that there are a high degree of competition. Buyers and sellers must be worried about participants in the market as well as potential new entrants. 4. There is perfect knowledge of the market, so all prices, technologies, and other factors about the good or service are known to everyone, so no one has an informational advantage. And 5. There are no market frictions, so things like transportation costs or selling costs do not exist. In real life, perfect competition rarely, if ever, exists, but it's still used regularly while discussing economic topics to help understand market forces. Let's take a look at an example. An example of a perfectly competitive good is a pineapple. When I go to the grocery store, I don't really have a preference for one pineapple or another. Generally, it's going to taste the same. The market for pineapples is pretty close to perfect competition, and the price of one pineapple is going to be the same as another. Buyers and sellers will take the market price. How is this different than the market for something, say, like branded sneakers or fancy restaurants? In those cases, there are huge differences between those goods and services from one another, and so their prices will vary. Those markets are not perfectly competitive. All right, now let's do a practice problem to see if you understand the idea of perfect competition. Which of the following goods or services most likely fall under perfect competition? 1. Cars. 2. Massage therapists. 3. Apples. Or 4. Video games. Take a moment and pause the video if you have to, and then we'll continue. All right, now let's reveal the answer. The answer is apples. Remember, you are looking for a good that is undifferentiated and generally is the same price across all markets. Let's walk through each of these answer choices. So for number one, cars, they have a lot of differences between one another from different models to years to performance standards, so the price of different cars will vary. Massage therapists can also vary between one another from different levels of experience to certifications, so they don't fall under perfect competition and they can have many different prices for their services. Apples are going to generally be the same price, since each apple is pretty undifferentiated from one another, so consumers and producers will take the market price and the market for apples fall under perfect competition. For number four, video games, these don't fall under perfect competition because there are tons of varieties and differences between them, from the type of game to age of the game to the quality. So again, the price will vary between different video games. Now let's recap what we learned today. First, we learn what is a market, which is basically buyers and sellers coming together to exchange their goods and services. Markets can be centralized or they can be decentralized. Next, we learn what is competition, which essentially means that buyers and sellers have multiple options. That means that the price for buyers and sellers will essentially start converging on what the price that they are willing to buy and sell for, which is also called the market price. And then lastly, we learn about perfect competition, which is a scenario where the good or the service is the exact same that's being offered. And so there are so many buyers and sellers that no one can impact the price. Everyone takes a single market price. All right, that wraps up our video on markets and competition. Thanks for watching, and I hope you check out other videos and topics on Chegg.